Specially designed for low-level bombing, the Mark III low-level bombsight makes use of an entirely new principle for indicating to the bomb aimer the instant at which the bomb should be released. The bomb aimer will realize that in a given set of conditions, there can be but one instant when a bomb released from his aircraft will fall along a path which ends at the chosen target. He may recall that when these lines are drawn, one vertically from the aircraft and one to the point of impact, they will define what is known as the bombing angle. He may recall some of the factors which determine the bombing angle and appreciate that when the bombing height is small, the bombing angle is comparatively large. The purpose of a bomb sight is to indicate to the bomb aimer that his aircraft has arrived at that point in space which is fixed by the bombing angle. This then is his sighting line at the proper instant for release. Other sighting lines would give inaccurate instants for release. The use of this sighting line would lead to undershooting the target. The use of this sighting line to overshooting the target. Here then are three sighting lines, each recording the bomb aimer's view of the target at three successive moments in the bombing run. The use of this line led to undershooting, and this to overshooting the target. This line was correct. How could the bomb aimer identify the correct line from the air? This is the bomb aimer's view of the target at the proper instant for release. The termination of the proper sighting line is marked by the letter C. The line of sight which led to undershooting is marked by the letter U. Whilst the one which led to overshooting is marked by the letter O. Now, during any given unit of time, there is a considerable difference in the angular displacement of the three points U, C, and O as seen by the bomb aimer. Notice that during the time involved, the ground at the point U will appear to have moved much less than has the ground at the point C, whilst the ground at the point O will appear to have moved much more. This, of course, is due to the differences in the angular velocities of the three points. The point C may be said to have an angular velocity peculiar to itself. Any device which could serve to identify the particular angular velocity of the point C would, at the same time, disclose the proper line of sight. The Mark III low-level bombsight has a graticule moving with a constant speed which can be set for the conditions of the attack. As all the lines have the same angular velocity, they provide a ready means for locating that point on the ground which has an angular velocity equal to that of the graticule. Notice, for example, that the more distant objects appear to move more slowly than the graticule. Whilst those in the immediate foreground have a speed much greater than the graticule. Somewhere in between, it is possible to identify where the speed of the ground and the speed of the line appear identical. It is here that the target will be in the given sighting line, and when it is, will be the instant for release. This viewpoint will show the idea in another way. Here is the aircraft with its given bombing angle. These dots serve to represent the end-on view of the moving graticule. The bomb aimer keeps his eye on the target. At first, his sighting line is overtaken by the moving dot. Now they match its speed, and now the sighting line moves faster than the dot. Watch again, and notice that it is only when the sighting line is correct for the bombing angle that its speed matches the speed of the moving dot. Watch again from the bomb aimer's position. Here's the target, lagging behind the graticule. It's catching up. Nearly. Now. Bomb gone. Now, where's that U-boat? Here she is. Stand by. Now. Look out, U-boat. Here we come. Steady. Steady.